you are having any problem in your working areas, okay, regarding the design, that the practices followed, then you may discuss, okay? Don't hesitate to raise any question or any problem pertaining to your power station or your working area, okay? Agree? So, yeah, how the switchyard look like, what are the functions of the switchyard that you discuss. Now, in this picture you see, this is the switchyard pertaining to a 437 megawatt gas power station, in which there are two gas turbines of 144.6 megawatt, and they are generating the power at a voltage of 10.5 kV, and then there is another switching transformer, steam turbine generator, which is having the capacity of 160 megawatt, and it is generating the power at 15.75 kV. And because this is low voltage, and if you transfer the power at these low voltages, then the value of the current for same power will be very high, and due to the high currents there will be severe losses into the transmission line. So we have got the generating transformer. The role of the generating transformer is to raise the voltage of the generator to higher voltage, say 220 kV or 400 kV. So in this case we raise the voltage to 220 kV because it is a small power station of 437 megawatt, and then this power is injected into a switchyard which has got three buses, 220 kV buses. Like the bus 1 is rating is 2500 ampere and 40 kilo ampere is the short circuit rating of these buses. Then there is another bus, 220 kV main bus 2, and we have got the transfer bus. Okay, the role of the transfer bus is that in case you face any problem in the circuit breaker, okay, breaker gas leaks, excessive gas leakage, then if there is any trouble in the breaker and you want to carry out the maintenance, then you need not to stop the generators. There is an alternate route which can be provided by these transfer bus, okay? And if you see the symbolical representation, then these are the 220 kV SSX breakers which are manufactured by ABB, and these are the isolators, 220 kV isolators. The role of the isolator is to isolate the part of the substation where you want to carry out the maintenance. And then we have got this current transformer. The role of the current transformer is to measure the current and transfer the high value of the current, say 1000 or 800 ampere to 1 ampere. Because you cannot inject the 800 or 1000 ampere into the measuring instruments and the protection relay. So we have to step down the current. So for stepping down the current, we need the current transformer. So they will transform the value of the current to 1 ampere. And then we have got this capacitive voltage transformer. The role of the capacitive voltage transformer is to reduce the voltage from 220 kV to 110 volt. Okay. So the secondary voltage is standardized. The switchyard can be 400 kV or 660 kV or 800 kV or 132 kV or 660 kV, irrespective of the magnitude of the primary voltage, we always have the secondary voltage 110 volt. The reason of keeping 110 volt secondary is that you can standardize. You can standardize your protection relay, you can standardize your commercial energy meters for 1 ampere. Okay, so you need not to go for different energy meters for different voltage rating of the substation. So like CT, they are standardized for 1 ampere, and the capacitive voltage transformer, they are standardized for 110 volt. there are wave traps. The purpose of wave trap is to block the communication signal, because these high voltage rating service station, they can communicate with the remote service station. So the same transmission line is used for transferring the communication signal from the same transmission line from which the power is flowing. The role of these wave trap is to stop the communication signal from entering into the service station. Any question, please? Yeah.
Sir, your CV, is it a vacuum or oil CV? Circuit breaker.
Circuit breaker?
Yeah.
These are the circuit breakers?
Yeah.
The
is it oil circuit breaker or vacuum circuit breaker?
Okay, oil circuit breaker is nowadays obsolete. From the safety point of view, we don't use oil circuit breaker. Okay, for low voltage circuit breaker, say 6.6 kV or 11 kV or 33 kV, mostly the vacuum circuit breakers are used. For extra high voltage, right from say 66 kV, 132 kV and 220 kV, we use the SFC circuit breaker. The reason of not using the oil circuit breaker is that when you open the contacts inside the oil of a oil circuit breaker, then what will happen? A arc will generate, and the temperature of the arc is around 20,000 degrees centigrade. So this mineral oil is a complex molecule of hydrogen and carbon. So in the presence of arc, which is having a temperature of 20,000 degrees centigrade, if hydrogen is generated and if your oil is not pure, if it is contaminated, if the dissolved air is there, okay, then what will happen? The oxygen will be there. Air is what? Air is a mixture of nitrogen and oxygen. So if oxygen is present in the air which has leaked into the oil due to the impurity in the oil, and hydrogen is generated, then it will be working as a hydrogen bomb. The hydrogen and oxygen mixture can ignite, and the huge forces will be generated and the oil circuit breaker will burst. So if you are using the oil circuit breaker, then there is a risk. If you are not able to maintain proper oil quality, okay, if the air gets leaked into the circuit breaker, that can make an explosive mixture during the opening and closing of the circuit breaker, and the circuit breaker may explode. That's why, due to the safety consideration, when the oil circuit breaker explodes, then what will happen? It is made up of porcelain. The porcelain will fly at the speed of aeroplane. And whosoever is working in the switch yard, the operating and the maintenance people, they can get injured. The another risk is that if the OCB bursts, then the huge quantity of the oil will spill into the ground, and it will contaminate the underground water. Okay, and if the oil, mineral oil or the OCB oil is mixed with the water, there is no technology by which you can purge out the oil from the water. So if such water somebody is drinking in a nearby society, then they can have a kidney failure and they can have a neuro diseases, the diseases which are related to brain. Okay, so due to these safety considerations, the use of oil circuit breaker is prohibited. It was used till 1980 and 90, now it is not used. It is replaced for medium class voltage circuit breaker by vacuum circuit breaker, and for high voltage system, extra high voltage system, by SFC circuit breaker. Are you clear?
Thank you.